Hello traders, Rich here, and here is a quick but detailed update on EURUSD. As usual, if you guys like video analysis, let me know in the comments or simply leave a like. So let's get started. As we clearly see, EURUSD has been overall bearish for a while, making lower highs and lower lows trading inside this falling brown channel. Moreover, it's currently approaching the upper bound, or what we call our non-horizontal resistance in brown. So we've got our impulse, flat correction, impulse, correction, impulse, and we are currently in this correction phase in the shape of the ascending triangle, as we can see in orange. So now we are around the upper bound of the orange ascending triangle and brown channel. That's why we are looking for sell setups on lower time frames from a short-term perspective. So we are trying to catch this small movement, and from a long-term perspective, for EURUSD to trade any lower, we need to see not only a break below the 1.13 or the lower orange trend line, but also below the 1.12. That's when the bears would prove control again, just like previously. Here's our last low broken downward. Now the bears proved control again to trade lower, and just like here as well, broke the previous low, now proved control again. So this is our last low here, which is around 1.12. So for the bears to take over, of course, if they break below this previous minor low, then we might say that they are taking over. But for them to take full control, we need to see a break below the entire structure, below the previous major low, which is around 1.12. In this case, here we go. In this case, the bears would prove control again and will be looking for sell setups on the retest. And vice versa, for the bulls to take over, we need to see a break of this entire range, right? So we need to see an aggressive movement upward, and then we'll be looking for buy setups on the retest, because then the bulls would break above the upper brown trend line, which is holding the price down, right, for so long, and also break above the entire structure, the entire ascending triangle, which are these previous highs. But anyway, let's take it step by step, right? But around the upper bound, we'll be looking for sell setups on lower time frames. If we zoom to H4, we can see the ascending triangle in a cleaner manner. And if you zoom into M30 time frame, we can see that EURUSD is overall bullish from a short-term perspective. However, since we are around the upper bound or resistance area, we'll be waiting for the sellers to take over by forming a third swing around the lower red trend line. Let me make it in gray as usual for our trigger swing. For those who know me, I always highlight it like this as our trigger, right? And then, and only then, the bears would take over from a short-term perspective, and we expect a movement to the lower bounds or the 1.13 and the lower orange trend line. Of course, if the sell is activated, the stop loss would be just above the previous swing high, and we target a 1-to-2 reward ratio, which, as mentioned previously, would be around the lower bound. Meanwhile, and until this happens, this scenario, EURUSD would be overall bullish from a short-term perspective, right? So higher highs, higher lows, and we can still trade higher and higher to break above the upper brown trend line, as mentioned from daily for the bullish scenario. But EURUSD can still trade a little bit higher, dive inside the resistance before going downward. Okay. So for example, if this happens and then price trades higher, then we might see another swing low form before we see the reversal. Anyway, you've got the idea, right? So we've got all the possible scenarios, but as usual, always wait for extra confirmation. We don't predict, we react. So let the market make the first move and then react accordingly. Best of luck, and I'll see you on the next one.